Hello, good people of the Notion community. This is Matt or Mr. Bio, and I'm here to give you a quick introduction to the Content Creator Notion template. Now, this template is something that I want to create in order to solve a lot of the common problems that most content creators face on an everyday basis. I have over 5 years of experience managing both micro influencers and macro influencers at companies like G Fuel, Opskins, and Control. And what I notice is that there are a lot of very common problems that content creators face on an everyday basis that can be very easily solved. Unfortunately, a lot of what content creators have to do nowadays is use a lot of different platforms like Google Drive, Asana, Monday, Google Sheets, etc., in order to try and package everything together for their entire operation. And if you've gone through that process before, you know just as well as I do that that's just not efficient. So, introducing the content creator template meant to solve all of those problems. So let's go ahead and go through a quick rundown of this template so that you know everything that's included in here. So first of all, on your dashboard, you can see that there are a few different categories that we're gonna dive into a little bit more in depth. But one of the things I wanna point out is that throughout this template, you're gonna see a lot of these different callouts where this little gray light bulb is. So whenever you buy the template, there will be a lot of instructions on how to use it to make sure that you can get the absolute most out of it. So now that we've covered that, let's talk about how this template works. Basically, imagine this as your central hub to be able to store everything content related when it comes to your brand. So at the very top here, what I want to do is kind of create a content status board. Now, this board is something that you can use either by yourself or if you have a team that you're working with, you can add them to this and you can work with them as well. But this allows you to see what the current progress is on content that you're producing. Now, keep in mind that this template is built for anybody creating content on any of the major platforms. So Twitch, Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, Discord, you name it, it's supported in here. But let's go ahead and dive a little deeper into each of these individual pages. First and foremost, your content overview, which is probably one of my favorite sections. This is basically your database of content. Everything that you produce and record can be stored here. At the very top, again, you can see the status of everything that you're producing, and you can filter everything by platform to make it a little bit easier, especially if you have a lot of projects going on. Below that, we also have organized by platform your upcoming content, stuff that has not been published just yet, but is on the way. And then at the very bottom, we have your published archive. This is where anything that you've published, whether it be a YouTube video, a TikTok video, a tweet, whatever the case may be, if you have it recorded in your content overview, it will appear here if it has already been published. Now, your asset library is where you can keep basically anything that you need, whether it be a template, a resource, a design piece, a photo, a video, whatever the case may be. If you want to keep this in your library, this is a much easier way to do it than trying to use Google Drive and Mediafire and Dropbox and all the different storage options available. You can still use those, but this allows you to keep everything organized. On top of that, you can search by the different tags that are available, and you can also filter by platform. Now, going back to the homepage, let's go ahead and talk about the sponsor section. One of the biggest pain points I've noticed with content creators is that it can always be a little difficult to track the sponsors that you're working with, making sure that you have the right information, and making sure that you get all the deliverables done that you have within your deal. This is basically a database where you can store all that information, everything from your discount code to your affiliate link, as well as the total spots or features that that sponsor has had with you. Now, if you open up one of these sponsored pages, you can actually see that you can store the contact information for your primary point of contact at that company. And on top of that, if you've done any sponsored content with them, you can actually link it here so that if they ever ask you, hey, did this get done? Did that get done? You can go ahead and pop in here and let them know what's upcoming as well as what's already finished. Going back to the dashboard, let's talk about collaborators real quick. There are plenty of content creators that love to collaborate with other creators, and that's a beautiful thing. What this allows you to do is essentially have a contact list of people that you've worked with and maybe want to work with again in the future. So each contact gives you the ability to include all of their social information as well as things like their email or their phone number, whatever the best way to contact them is. You can also see what specific content in your content overview that you've already collaborated with them on. And on top of that, you can also mark down when your last collaboration with them was in case you want to make it more of a regular thing. Moving on to the final section, we have your goals and milestones. Now, it's very, very, very important as a creator to set some overall goals for yourself. Set some lofty goals. You want to hit 5 million subscribers? Go ahead and write it down. Now, here's where this section can help you out. So first of all, whenever you create a goal, you can choose what platform it's associated with. On top of that, if you have multiple people that are working on your brand, if you have a team, you can actually assign goals to individual members of of your team. Now, on top of that, to make things a little bit more fun and interactive, I actually have a milestone section that's created, which is basically taking your overall goal and breaking it down into smaller steps to make it more achievable. So whenever you create a new goal, you can go ahead and create these milestones. And as you complete them, you can go ahead and check them off. And if you notice a little progress bar right here, it updates as you complete them. And then once a goal is fully complete, it will appear here in the completed goals so that you can go ahead and focus on the ones that are still active. And that is the general overview and introduction of the content creator template. Again, I want to create this in order to solve a lot of the problems that I was seeing content creators face on an everyday basis, whether that be trying to find a solution for your content schedule or being able to delegate tasks to your team or be able to keep track of sponsor deliverables or different assets and goals that you have within your brand. This is meant to be your all-in-one solution as a creator. Whether you have a small audience or a large audience, whether it's just you as a solo creator or you're a creator that has a team behind you helping you, this is built for every kind of creator that's looking to save more time and work more efficiently so that you've got more time to focus on growing your brand and your audience. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments if you're on YouTube, or hit me up on Twitter at That's Mr. Bio. I hope that you enjoyed, and I can't wait to hear what you think about it. And until next time, I'll see you next time.